What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Thank you so much for tuning in. It's me, Mikey Pipes. Monday morning, June 16th, 2025. A few minutes to 8 here in the morning in the great state of New York. Heading to a new residential client who's got a Hayward heat pump pool heater. Gentleman called the office last week and said he's got a push the fan blade with a stick to get it going, and then the fan stops shortly thereafter. Let's go check it out, hopefully get him up and running. Did I say hopefully? Ye who hopes dies in despair.
Alright, how old is this bad boy?
I'd say 8 to 10 years old.
When's the last time you had serviced?
I don't know, 5 years ago,
four years ago. Was it maintenance or repair?
Repair.
What was wrong?
I don't know, to be quite frank with you.
Don't remember?
I don't remember. Okay. Maybe you just changed the capacitor, but I'm not sure.
Okay.
It didn't last long.
How do you turn the pump on? Because right now the pump's not on and has a pressure switch error.
So if I bring that heat to whatever, 90. Stick the screwdriver in here. Let's start the guy. My pool guy looked at it. He had took the front off and he detached two wires and he connected them. Seemed to work for a little while.
Oh yeah?
I thought maybe he bypassed. I think he bypassed.
Hope it didn't blow.
He's one of these MacGyver guys. No, I don't think he did.
Oh, okay. Let's see what it does after compressor delay.
Yeah, so if I was to stick the screwdriver in and spin it, it would work.
Okay. All right, turn that off again, the pump.
All right, I removed the screws that hold the electrical cover to the front of the unit. So we have the compressor coming on, but the fan wasn't running. And what I want to look for is how blown up that capacitor is right there. All right, let's kill power to this. I'm gonna guess it's gonna be that one there. Nope. Let's get the 40. I should have known better. It's a compressor. Why would it be a 20 amp breaker? Gotta protect your knees, folks. All right, now that the power display is gone, let's get our multimeter and double check that there's no power coming in on L1 and L2 to the bottom of that two-pole contactor for the compressor. All right, let's go to ground. And nothing, nothing, and together, also nothing. All right, let's play with this capacitor. There's the very pregnant fan capacitor. And here is the compressor, an 80 microfarad, and this is a 7.5 microfarad. Let's discharge any potential juice there by touching those two together. And let's test our capacitor as well. Okay. Let's pull off the brown and the two yellow wires, the pair of needle nose. Let's see if I could set you. Okay. Now, let's set our meter to read capacitance and test. Nothing. Absolutely nothing. Didn't expect to see anything there anyway. Damn, she blew up. Damn, she's like 8 months pregnant at least.
Wow.
What do you think? About 4 or 5 months pregnant? Well, closer to 8. It's a boy or a girl. What do you guess? All right, I got a new capacitor. Another 7.5. Reading 7.6. Let's get her in there wired up and test her. fire up. All right, set the system to manual mode. That way I can get the pump to run. Let's see what happens. Right now we just have dash, dash, dash. Pool light is green. After a compressor delay, system should kick on. And that should run by itself. 66. Seven pool temperature. Weird. Should have came on 68 degrees, set point is 90. I don't see anything except the time delay preventing it from coming on right now. Set point is 90, pool is on, water is 68, 67 degrees. There you have it. Abracadabra. All right, let's take some temperature readings. My discharge air temperature on top of the condenser fan motor is reading 54.3 degrees. Ambient is gonna be closer to 62. Let's check pool temperature. It looks like 68 degrees. And 72. Good. And after a 4 minute compressor delay, the system turned back on. If you live in the Long Island, New York City metropolitan area and you're tired of getting bamboozled by your HVAC contractor, or you have a pool heater heat pump that needs repair, service, or replacement, I want you to pick up the phone and give me a call, 516-348-6300, or save time, book online at pipedoc.net. You can also scan in that QR code right there for service. Catch you in the next one. Be well, God bless, stay safe.